Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. This is the second part of the video, and if you have not seen the first part where I have done the face and the jewelries, you can check out the first part. The link is in the description. Also, you can click on this I button. So to begin with this illustration, we will be doing the garment today, and we will cover the base first. For the base color, I'm taking all my watercolor tubes, and you can see the color names here. I will be using combination of these colors, and I will mix them to create a nice base for the garment. So starting with the colors, scarlet, crimson and orange, I will mix and match the colors, and I will create a base which can give this multiple shade effect. You can also go with a single color base and use some black to give the shading, but here I felt like experimenting a little bit, so I decided to mix some colors and then have fun with coloring the base as well, guys. So here we are doing the base color first, and this illustration is on the A3 size, so it took me a good amount of time. Talking about the paper, this is ivory sheet. Now ivory sheet are not very great for watercolor layering, so here you can see I've like kept the watercolor not very diluted. I have kept it kind of solid, so you can also use poster color as well. So here I will try to do the color, and I will wait a little bit before applying a second layer of the color. So for working on the ivory sheet, it's important that you let the layers dry, otherwise if you put too much water over it, the paper will be damaged and it will start tearing. So this is the problem with ivory sheet if you are doing with watercolor, but with little precaution you can definitely work out on it as well. So yeah, watercolor, poster color, anything can be used for doing the base. Definitely also you can go for markers, brush pens, anything. So in the similar color manner, I will cover the lehenga as well, and will be using vertical strokes for this one. Here you can see I have kept little bit of the spacing for the detailing portion here. You can do the base color entirely also, after that you can do your detailing, but here just to keep little bit of the trace marks, like for the detailing part, I've kept the bottom portion blank and I will color it later on. Okay, so here we can do an interesting thing is that we can mix little bit of burnt sienna to the red color to make it little bit darker. You can definitely add this color instead of black, and just see when we mix this color, it becomes more near to that maroon color family, and yeah, this color goes really well when we are doing on this red color palette. We shall be using this color for the corner folds and the shadows. So first start from the corners, put the color, and then you can do little bit of the blending. For the blending part, you can take little water, you can dab your brush on the tissue paper and just spread the color across, so that you have little bit of the base color as well and little bit of the darker color as well. For the folds, simply give the fold lines and you are good to go. Okay, so this is how you can do the blending part. Just take little water on the palette and dab your brush, clean the brush, and then spread the wet brush over the color. So this will blend that darker shadows softly over the original base, that is the base color. So you can just dab your wet brush very softly to blend in the darker shadows. At the end of the shadows, you can take a little bit of black, either poster or water, and then mix with the base color, and we shall be giving that final shadows and the folds here. So guys, here you can see how I'm doing the folds, and you can mix little water to that color so that it becomes little diluted and easier to spread the color well. And remember the folds here, the garment is quite heavy and it's on the darker side, so you can give the folds in a very darker part and use good amount of black here. So when you are doing the base, you can either go layer by layer, like doing the base color first, after that adding little more darker color to it, at the end you are adding the black. Or you can do the same thing which I'm doing here to save my time, but to give the similar effect. What I'm doing is that I'm picking the colors directly from my palette. You can take all the colors on your palette and just move your brush and give the colors layer by layer. So in this way you can work quickly and also create this multiple tones and shades in your base color as well, and by giving the shadows and everything in one go. So yeah, when you are learning, you can definitely go in layer by layer, and later on as you get comfortable with your colors, you can definitely experiment a lot to understand your own way of coloring and to develop your own style of coloring. So base color is done finally, and I will quickly color the borders as well. For the borders I have used orange, and after that I can mix little red also over it. So over and all I've tried to give little bit different shading to this different sections here, so that I'm not confused while I do that detailing portion. Of course you can do the base color entirely with a single shade, after that you can mark the detailing portion with a pencil or just trace the entire design over that base. So here I tried to do it little differently. Here you can see guys all the multiple shades of that red, scarlet and the orange palette. Okay, so finally we are at the detailing part, and I have used white poster color to create a base for the color. Also, one more thing you can do is that directly mix that yellow ochre or the brownish color to your white and then do the detailing at one go. That can also be done, but here since I will be using metallic color, that is acrylic color, over the white base, so I have done this plain white details with this detailing brush, and after this has completely dried, then I will be using the other medium over it. So yes, white creates a very good base, and you can show any form of detailing like zardozi embroidery or any kind of thread embroidery or sequins work, any other form of work which are very famous in this kind of ethnic wear and bridal wears. So here you can see I've created all these detailings with the white color itself. So don't mix too much water to it. Try to keep the white color solid, and if you mix too much water, the white will look very diluted. So you can go layer by layer again with the white color. What I mean is that guys, if your white fades, it will not give a very good kind of detailing. So if the white fades, you can go again with the white color. So here you can see going with the red color again to give it in between that white detailing to show the fabric a little bit here and there. So you have your colors on your palette, just spread it very creatively and cleverly wherever you feel like. And after the base is done, finally I will be using that acrylic color. So this is from the Fabrica brand. You can use any other medium as well, like watercolor, poster color. I felt like using this metallic colors, and these are acrylic colors. So I have used disposable plate here, and I will pick the color from here and just spread it over the white base. You can also mix two of the color in the golden and this bronze shade. You can mix both of them and also spread it over the base. So again, I have taken little bit of the black and will use it for the detailing portion again to make the detailing look little bit heavy and also to create the final folds here. You can see that I have diluted the black little bit with water and just creating it in between the detailing portion here, that embroidery portion here, so that the embroidery looks kind of very heavy. So by adding black, I'm trying to create that heavy border look here with lots of golden shine and this heavy work. I shall be posting the links of all the materials in the description box below, and also check out the previous videos as well. And we are going to start a new series on menswear very soon, so stay tuned guys, and hope you are enjoying this video. Here you can see I am adding the final shades of the black here to make my embroidery look quite heavy. So in the similar manner and the layering part, I will be completing the detailing over this lehenga as well. So I have fast forwarded the video. Enjoy the process guys, and here you can see that how I've done the base color and the layering part. So you can totally go very creative with the color. Sometime you can forget the technical part and just go with the flow of spreading the color and just enjoying the whole process of coloring it. So do try this out. I will be posting the link of the reference picture as well. And yes, it's important that you give the credit of the picture which you have taken for reference, and for the learning purpose you can take reference pictures and learn it. And also, it's not necessary guys that you have to do it on A3. If you don't have A3 size paper, you can also do it on your own choice of paper as well. So here, after it's done, that detailing portion is done, you can see finally I'm done with the detailing portion. Here I'm using black color pencil to give that final shading. I have to create some more depth to it, and that's why I'm using this very darker shade of the black. So with good amount of pressure I'm putting the color, and also in between that embroidery portion, because yes, it's a heavy embroidery, so it will cast a good amount of shadow on the fabric. So create depth between the folds and just outline some of that portion near that embroidery section, and yeah, just outline the folds quite well, and you are done with this whole shading part. But yeah, again, when you are doing the shading part, you have to give good amount of time to it so that it looks quite nice and it should blend well. So again, remember guys, when you do the folds, it's not just some single lines, you are cutting some single lines, it's not that. You have to blend in the color really well. Along with black, you can also use white color to give in center of the folds or just beside that black color to show the shine of the fabric. If it's something like silk fabric, you can definitely show that little bit of extra shine with a white pencil or glass marker as well. Okay, so done with the illustration. I will be giving little bit of shadow here, that is the shadow casted by the lehenga. So just dilute your black color with water and spread the color. Just follow the same silhouette line. So finally done, guys. I hope you enjoyed the whole process, and if you are new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe, and I shall see you all very soon with another interesting tutorial. And keep illustrating, keep practicing, take care, bye bye.